That new show I was talking to you about, that's this.
Put that blanket back, because you know you're about to fall asleep immediately.
Man, ain't nobody about to fall asleep.
Hey, do you freaks remember anything about that life, you know, from before?
Like a bunch of alcoholics with patience. Pissed off. Strong. Want to tear your guts out.
Long time no see.
Blair, you weren't looking fine today.
Good choice. Okay. Yeah, good. Yep. Good one. Good choice. Yep.
Job for you.
Ricky.
Hey.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll check in. Thank you now.
Bet you're here for your bike, right?
We got gas.
We're gonna run out of this.
See ya.
Can I help you?
I got a job for you.
What do you got?
You remember the other day? I took you by the backside. Food came up his face.
Yeah, Wheeler was on watch.
He was doing more than watching. He was robbing this blind. He and a few men took off to a camp north of Patchen's Lake. You know the one?
Yeah, I know it.
Find that bastard to kill him. He's got a pocket watch. Still works. Bring it to me.
Wheeler, got it.
Got you.
Tucker. I got him.
Nice job.
I guess we're sorry you messed with Ada Tucker now.
No, I guess he's not feeling a whole lot of anything.
I've updated your credits. And you wait and see. I'm still going to find a way to talk you and Boozer into joining us here. Become a part of the family.
Yeah. Good luck with that.
Hey, Ricky.
What's up?
Mitchell and a couple guys were on run northwest of here. When they were hit by a group of drifters. They tracked them back to camp north of the Lava Lake.
Okay, so Mitchell and the others need to take them out.
They're not drifters, Zeke. And Mitchell's just a kid. I don't even know if he can use a gun.
What the hell are they doing out here?
Look, I need to do this. Lost Lake needs you.
Okay, great. I'll take care of it.
Thank you.
You here to buy something?
Hey, Buzz.
All right, I got you. Should have new shit. Bit later. Stop by.
First one. How does it work? Last day it turned out.
That's it.
Ricky. I'm at Malacqua Lake. Yeah, there's a camp full of drifters here.
Can you handle them?
Yeah, I got this. Deacon out. Take this.
Men coming!
Oh, come on. Time to clear this camp. All right, boys. What you thought? You just set up camp in Lost Lake territory.
Someone's here.
Now we just gotta let Ricky know it's done. Ricky, it's done. I cleared out the camp full of drifters. No. North of Malacqua Lake.
Thanks, Deke. I'll let Iron Mike know.
Be sure to let Mitchell know it's safe to play outside again.
He's just a kid, Deke.
Yeah, well, if he wants to live long enough to become an adult, he better start learning how to use a gun.
Yeah, you're right. I'll start working with him. Thanks, Deke.
Deacon.
those cats.
How'd I ever trust this asshole? Hello. Guess Skizza won't be needing this.
Gotta go see Addy. Get this arm fixed up. Can't let it get infected. We know what that means.
I can't do this anymore.
It's okay, I'm fine. What's going on?
I'm a goddamn veterinarian. I went to school to cure colic and heaves and hoof diseases. Does this look like a fucking hoof to you?
Addy?
No,
Addy?
You saw what happened to Boozer. I can't do this.
Hey, shh. Addy.
So many wounded.
Addy.
And so many dying.
Addy.
Deacon, I am not a doctor.
Okay, maybe not. But you're all we've got. So Addy's not a doctor, huh? Okay, so you're not a doctor and you still save Boozer's life.
I wonder about the freaker sometimes, you know?
That's like, gotta count for something.
Do they feel pain? Anything?
Hey, Deke. So I want to go check on the explosives to make sure, you know, the Rippers didn't steal them, and then I went to Skizzo's cabin to check on the deck cords, but I should have just come straight here and saved some time.
Get the hell out of here, Ricky.
I guess we can go blow up that cave, right? I'll come with you.
When I was a kid, my dad found a rat's nest underneath one of our sheds. You want to know what he did?
Can't even guess.
Well, I waited till morning. They'd all be asleep. He laid a piece of plywood over the hole and told me to go get the garden hose. And he said to me, I never forget what he said to me. He said the best way to kill a rat's nest is to drown him.
You can blow up the reservoir above the camp?
Oh, that's an idea.
Deacon, you can't.
They want to rest in peace? I'm going to help him out.
Deacon, you can't do that.
Why is that? Because Iron Mike? Is this some fucking treaty? You know, I want to cut Skizzo's throat, but he's right about one thing. Carlos ain't gonna stop, Rippers ain't gonna stop, and you know it.
Are you sure this isn't personal?
Fuck yeah, it's personal.
Boozer, I'm heading to the gate. You ready?
Way ahead of you, brother.
Okay, I'm almost there.
Nice rifle.
Oh, yeah, a little present from Schizo.
Remind me to be there when you give it back to him.
He'll be there.
That goddamn Schizo.
So what are we gonna do with the bastard? I mean, we're not letting Iron Mike put him on trial, are we?
No, we're not!
All right, so what's the plan?
I know the area pretty well. Sarah, she worked out of a lab south of Iron Butte Ranch. I used to ride out there, pick her up for lunch. Harder to ride on some of those back roads. Jesse, Carlos, whatever the hell he's calling himself, he's taking over the old golf course and resort. Just south of the lodge is the Crescent Lake Reservoir. Now, we blow that dam, that lake's gonna flood down into the valley and it's gonna drown them all, like rats.
Okay, but isn't the lodge up on a hill?
Yeah, flood probably won't do much to it, but it'll do enough damage to the rest of the Ripper compound to take out most of his men.
And if Jesse survives, he won't see us coming.
Moose man, stay with me! Goddamn Schizo.
So what are we gonna do with the bastard? I mean, we're not letting Iron Mike put him on trial, are we?
No, we're not.
All right, so what's the plan?
I know the area pretty well. Sarah, she worked out of a lab south of Iron Butte Ranch. I used to ride out there, pick her up for lunch. Harder to ride on some of those back roads. Jesse, Carlos, whatever the hell he's calling himself. He's taken over the old golf course and resort. Just south of the lodge is the Crescent Lake Reservoir. Now, we blow that dam, that lake's gonna flood down into the valley and it's gonna drown them all, like rats.
Okay, but isn't the lodge up on a hill?
Yeah, flood probably won't do much to it, but it'll do enough damage to the rest of the Ripper compound to take out most of his men.
And if Jesse survives, you won't see us coming.
You got it.
Now we just gotta figure out how to get into the Iron Butte Valley without being seen, yeah?
I'll get us there. You just hang on.
Ripper Patrol!
Rippers! I got him!
open.
Behind you.
Head south from here.
Following you.
God damn it.
This easy.
Nope.
Okay. Hey, what are you doing?
Figured I'd take this bag of explosives down there and ask them if they didn't mind us, you know, blowing them the fuck up.
Boozer.
Look, you stay up here with Schizo's rifle and keep them off me while I set the charges.
Oh, hold on.
Look, I got this. Not much good in a firefight, but I can plant these charges.
I've set demo charges before, Boozer, in Afghanistan. I know exactly where to put them.
Good. Tell me where to go when I'm down there. We doing this?
Yeah.
All right.
Okay, I'm gonna be up in this tower. Should give me a good view of the entire dam.
I'll wait here until you get up there.
Stay low. Move fast.
You got it, brother.
Loser! Never mind. Go, go!
Where do I set the first charge?
You see the second set of scaffolding on top of the dam?
Okay. Heading there now. Alright, I'm setting the first charge.
Keep going.
Take. Fall asleep there? What's going on, brother?
Try it, Boozer!
And I'm setting the second charge.
Just move your ass.
Kind of busy here. You got him?
So, unless, wait a minute, was this already?
Well, that never gets old, does it? What's up? Let's go find Jesse.
You did a hell of a job back there.
Yeah? I thought I was done for a couple of times.
I'm sorry about that.
What the hell are you talking about? This is the most alive I've felt since... shit. You remember when we got trapped by that horde in Tumalo?
We ain't done yet.
How many you think we killed?
I don't know. They had it coming, right?
Yeah, they had it coming. Guess we all do.
All right, looks like we go in on foot from here. You want to stay?
keep any stray rippers from ripping off my bike?
Yeah, I don't think we need to worry about that. And fuck that. This is on Jesse. You want some payback? I'll show him some fucking payback.
Come on, let's head to the lodge.
Like I said, right behind you.
Jesus.
This must be what it looked like after Noah's flood. Came and washed away all the wicked.
Yeah, except God had nothing to do with this one.
Yeah. You get my point.
Ah, shit! More rippers.
How the hell did they survive?
Oh, they didn't. They just don't know it yet.
Dink! Our left! Our left!
Yeah, yeah, I got this.
Hey! Over here, you son of a bitch!
Yeah, that's a breaker. Jesse.
Oh, yeah. It's time to finish what we started.
These guys seem more jacked up than usual.
Hell yeah. They must have snorted up the rest of whatever the hell drug they take.
Got it.
There's no way you're getting up there.
Carol. Damn it.
Here. No. I'll boost you up. Okay, listen. Something happened to me. There's a trail not far from here.
No. Listen, that is not Carlos up there, okay? Not this founder. Rest in peace. It's fucking Jesse Williamson. Fucking low-life piece of shit scumbag who got what was coming to him. All right. Now you fucking go up there and kill that son of a bitch.
time to get low, brother! Time to get low.
Deacon St. John, brought low by the lowly Jesse Williamson. Brought low. Do you remember back in the day? You and Boozer held me down while Chick burned the flesh on my back. Those memories kept me from being free. Chick thought I was gone.
Good being out in the shit again, you know. I gotta say, shoveling shit and pulling weeds. I don't know, maybe it isn't such a bad way to spend the day.
Yeah.
Well, with Jesse gone, how many you think are left? People that we knew from before, I mean.
No one. Boozer, there's no one left.
Shit. Sorry.
Yeah. Me too. Come on, let's get the fuck out of here.
Like I said, I know we haven't talked in a few years. I guess I disfigured with my Elizabeth being there with you and all. Probably wasn't much point in me yammering away at you. Oh, and then with all hell breaking loose, I thought maybe you weren't there. Or you just didn't give a shit. Pardon my language. I guess that's why I'm here. See, I still don't know. I hope you're there. Hope there's some reason for all this shit we're living through. That's all. We'll talk again some other time. Amen. Deke?
Yeah, Ricky told me that I could find you here.
Oh! It's just these knees of mine, you know. It's reason I haven't been praying all these years. Yeah, I'm not a church-going type. Even after living through that shitstorm in Sherman's camp. But now, after all this, I just thought, hell, maybe now it's the time.
I didn't have a choice, Mike.
Oh, everybody's got a choice, Deke. Until they're dead.
It's either us or them.
It's always us or them. Always. You know the reason we're going to hell? Is we can't figure out that us is every goddamn soul that ain't walking around in shit-stained pants trying to eat us!
All right, you know what? You may not like it, but the world is what it is. Yeah, it is. Praying ain't gonna change that. Wishing that it was something else ain't gonna make it that way, Mike.
Wishing ain't got anything to do with it. We make the world what it is by what we do. All of us. I let him go. Schizo. Ain't no way he was getting a fair trial.
You let him go.
Told him to ride out, not come back.
Jesus Christ, Mike, do you have any idea what the fuck you've done?
Yeah. I stopped another killing. You know what? I guess I'm good with that.
First one, I was at work. Last day, it turned out. Behind the counter. Hey, Deke.
Hi. Hey, I heard. You know? I mean, what you did for us, how you... The Rippers, all of them, I just... I know you had to do it. What else was gonna stop him, you know?
Yeah, look, Blair, I'm not proud of what I had to do. You know that, right? I mean, we had to... Look, they were coming.
Yeah, I know. You don't have to explain anything to me. I was here when they attacked, remember? I don't know. I guess I'm just tired, you know?
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, good. Yep. Okay, then. Hey, come around more often.
No, this is your clutch.
I know where the clutch is.
Do you want me to show you how to do this or not?
Yes, but I know where the clutch is.
Okay, fine. All right, you do it yourself, okay?
Fine.
Hey! What are you doing? You can't park here.
I'm just here to pick
it's
up, sir.
It's private property. Now turn around, get the hell out of here. Come on.
Okay.
Move it.
Yep.
Okay, you know what, though? I think I'm just gonna wait right here. You can go back to doing your guard the cornfields thing.
This is Officer Moore at the gate. We got an issue here. Hey, listen, asshole. This is a restricted area. I told you, get the hell out of here. Okay. Hey, you just wait right there. I told you. Move it.
It's like I was trying to say. I'm just here to pick up...
Did you not see that sign?
Oh, look at that. That's kind of hard to miss.
I'm authorized to use deadly force.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
Whoa, what's going on?
I'm sorry, Miss Whitaker.
It's fine.
Do you know this asshole?
Yeah, he's with me. He's with me.
Sorry, ma'am. I didn't know that...
It's fine. Honestly, I apologize.
Shh. Oh, and Jim!
Deacon.
I'm not with her. She's with me.
Hold on tight.
Why do you always do that?
Do what?
Act like such a dick.
Oh, come on. He started it.
What are you, five?
Hey, watch the clutch. Remember, you gotta give it enough gas, rev up the RPMs.
I got this.
Yeah, I can hear. Where are we headed?
Over to the dam. That's a nice quiet road, right?
Are you driving? No.
Are we still going out tonight? You said something might come up.
Crap, yeah. Boozer and the boys want to ride down to Clam Estate, visit Jack.
So you're gonna blow me off to go see some guy in prison?
Jack's not some guy.
I know. I was kidding.
Oh, shit, look out!
Oh, God. Oh, my God. Jesus. I don't know what it is, but every time I'm on a bike with you, some idiot in a truck tries to run us off the road.
Oh, my God. No. Listen. You did great. Most people, they would have panicked. They would have oversteered, and that would have gotten us killed.
I almost did get us killed. I was...
No.
I wasn't paying attention, and I was distracted.
Hey, it's okay. Just breathe. You're okay. Wait a second. What did you mean, distracted?
No, it's just stuff going on at work. It's nothing. I just...
Oh. Okay. I just thought maybe you saw my new... patch.
You're what? No. Nomad? Wait, you quit the club?
No, I didn't quit the club. I would never quit the club. Nomad, what it means is, well, I'll be less involved from now on.
Deke, I didn't ask you to do that.
Oh, I know. And if you had, I would have said no. You ready to try this again?
Yeah. I mean, no, but yeah, I will.
Thank you for saving my life.
Well, you know, I do what I can.
Hey, the clutch.
I know what the clutch is.
Oh, okay, none of that.
Deacon.
So, do you think your parents are gonna come?
To the wedding? I don't know.
I mean, you know, I thought if I stepped back from the MC that,
I don't think it's gonna matter to them, Deacon.
But you're gonna at least tell them.
Yeah, if you want me to. Look, it's just... I'm not gonna change who I am and who you are to make my uptight, middle-class parents happy.
Okay. Look out.
I see them.
Hey, are they headed to your work?
Oh, shit. What about the MC? Are any of them coming now that you've gone Nomad?
Oh, I don't know. Probably been a while since any of them set foot in a chapel, and you really want 27 Harleys rolling up in that little church in Marion Forks?
Yeah. You know what? As a matter of fact, I do.
Okay.
Miss Whitaker's returning.
What's going on?
I don't know.
Miss Whitaker.
Yeah?
Chief's been trying to get a hold of you, says it's urgent.
It's always urgent. Let him know I'll be right there.
Okay.
I gotta go.
Hey.
Sorry. It's fine. It's probably just a fire alarm or something small.
Okay. How come dead?
Love you. Just call me later.
Addie, I'm sorry.
Whatever.
Addie.
Whatever, Ricky.
I'm sorry.
God damn. Clearance. O'Brien, this is St. John. Come back. O'Brien, this is St. Just answer your goddamn radio.
St. John, didn't think I'd hear from you again.
Yeah, neither did I. All right, listen, that night you bugged out. You told me that you didn't take any civilians. You just took Nero personnel, feds, people with clearance.
Shut up.
Listen to me. Sarah, my wife, she had clearance. She had her ID badge with her the night that I put her on your chopper.
Just
do me a favor, look it up. Sarah Irene Whitaker. She worked at Cloverdale. She had federal clearance. She was doing, research, pharmaceutical. I don't know what the hell she was doing.
I'll see what I can find.
Okay, great. O'Brien, remember, you owe me.
Yeah. O'Brien out.
I was in my classroom when, I taught English at Shamal Community College to a bunch of stay-at-home moms.
St. John, this is O'Brien. Us.
O'Brien, what do you
anyway,
got?
We heard all
I need to see you in person.
I thought it was a shooting at first.
Jesus, O'Brien, just would you tell me what you found? Is she alive or isn't she?
I have something to give you. Like,
O'Brien?
Right or something.
I've transmitted the coordinates.
I saw Karen.
Meet me there. O'Brien out.
Lock their doors.
O'Brien.
Oh, I ran.
God damn it.
In the next few days, look.
Iron Mike's looking for you. He said...
Booze, man, listen. Just tell him I'll be back. I gotta... You remember what I told you? The night that Sarah died, Nero, they bugged out. They only took their own people, feds, and people who had federal clearance levels.
Wait, Deke, what the hell are you talking about?
Look, it's probably enough.
Deke, hold on.
Something I gotta do. Deacon out. What information, O'Brien? What the hell could you possibly have left to say? That I would give a damn about.
Deke, you there? This is Lost Lake. Come in.
Hey, Mike, what's up?
Ricky told me you took care of that drifter camp. North of Malacqua Lake?
Yeah, they won't be bothering us anymore. Hey, Mike, that kid, Mitchell, he really shouldn't be going out on runs unless he can take care of himself.
Yeah. God damn it. I'll take care of it. Thanks, Deke. Iron Mike out.
A Nero beacon. Wonder what they were doing up here.
Deke? Hey, we got a job for you.
Ricky. Hey,
Okay. Yeah, I'll check in. Deacon out.
Neuro injector. Just what the doctor ordered.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall say.
No, I don't think so, Cope. Not today.
Thank you.
Another bounty. Possibly have left to say that I would give a damn about.
So what the hell?
I managed to recruit a few guys who I trust, like me, aren't happy with what's going on.
So why am I here?
I wanted to give you this. You were right about your wife.
Where did you get this?
When Silver Lake evacuated, they took Nero personnel, federal officials, and well, Sarah Irene Whitaker had a Class 4 federal clearance level.
Clearance level?
Your wife bugged out with a recon unit east of Fort Rock.
Take me there.
No.
No? Well, you got a ride. We're all friends now.
The base is gone.
What?
A year ago. Local militia group.
Militia group? Where's their camp?
We don't know.
How the hell can you not know? You got a helicopter. You got satellites.
Somewhere around Crater Lake, but it's a no-fly zone, okay? They got outposts, rockets, RPGs.
Crater Lake.
Crater Lake. I wanted to tell you about the work we're doing. Studying the infected, the freaks. They're evolving. As bad as things are right now, they're gonna get worse. A lot worse.
Boozer? Booze man, come back.
Yeah, Dean.
Hey, listen to me. A year ago, we were with Iron Mike. We were thinking about riding south, but the Santiam Pass was blocked. There was no way through, and he said that he knew another way.
Dean, Iron Mike, he's not...
Girl, that's it. So, what were you saying?
Dean, Iron Mike, he's not too happy with us right now.
Just listen to me, just listen to me. Do you remember what he said?
Iron Mike? Yeah, he was bragging about knowing every goat trail in 100 miles. Said there was a trail that went around Mount Thielson. Out of something.
Thielson, man, that's it. Thielson Pass.
Yeah, why the hell you...
Shit.
You talked to him? She's alive? Sarah's alive?
Hey, listen to me. O'Brien, they, Boozer, he found her ID back. Boozer, I
never lost
Okay, you were saying?
Dee, you never lost hope. You always knew. You never gave up. So what are you gonna do?
I don't know, Boozer. I don't know, but... God, if there's even a chance that she's alive, I... Well, I gotta find her.
Shit, I gotta go. Ricky and Addy need help putting up a shelf or some goddamn thing. Look, I'll see you when you get back to camp. Boozer out.
Okay. See you, Booze Man. Hey, Ricky. I got some shit I gotta take care of.
Are you coming back?
I'm not coming back. What do you mean?
Boozer told us.
Okay, look. There's nothing to tell.
There's no way over the Sanium Pass. You know that.
Yes, I'm coming back. Listen, like I said, I got some shit to do. Deacon out.
Somebody's at the gate. Oh, it's just Deke.
Deke, how's my favorite bounty hunter? I got all kinds of stuff. Yeah, good. Yep. Good one. Okay. Good choice. Yeah, good. Yep. Okay, then. Deke, take care now.
Everybody keeps getting by while I sit here. I keep getting high. How can I do this to myself? I can't look in the mirror in my own fucking house. And I don't really love me, but baby, you're killing me. And I don't really wanna be alone. But when you're around, all we do is fight. And I can't sing no more. My motivation up and walked out the door. And every time I try to scream again, my empty heart stops beating, leaving me with no friends. And I don't really love me, but baby, you're killing me. And I don't really wanna be alone tonight. But when you're around, all we do is fight. everybody keeps getting by while I sit here. I keep getting high. How can I do this to myself? I can't look in the mirror in my own fucking house. And I don't really love me, but baby, you're killing me. And I don't really wanna be alone tonight, but when you're around, all we do is fight. And I don't really love me, but baby, you're killing me. And I don't really wanna be alone tonight, but when you're around, all we do is fight.
You here to buy something?
Buzz.
Okay. I'll top you off.
So, a couple months ago, we were up by crazy.
Stop by anytime.
Scavenging, you know. I thought maybe the place.
Deke, we really need your help.
Ricky, hey, what's wrong?
I just got a radio call from Jeremy.
Jeremy?
Givens? He's that kid who wrote in a few days ago. Remember the group he was with that got wiped out near Tumalo? I assigned him marsh duty, but evidently Jeremy isn't much for taking orders.
Okay, yeah, but a radio call, why is he out in the shit?
He wanted to prove himself, go on a supply run by himself. Anyway, he ran out of gas near a farm northwest of here. I made a note on your map. Can you find him before...
Yeah, before he gets himself killed, sure. I'll have a look around.
Got good shit in stock today.
I got it. Stay safe out there.
Hey, Ricky, this, farm, where is it exactly?
It's right across from the bridge that leads to the farm. It'll be on the left.
Okay, hold on. You mean the Lost Lake farm? Got it. Deacon out.
At last.
Okay, this has gotta be it. Yeah, out of gas, so workbench. Grab the gas can. Where are you going, Jeremy? Oh, shit. Hey, Ricky, I found his bike.
He's not there?
No, looks like he's heading into Sherman's camp.
Jesus, Deke.
Look, he's probably at the gas station trying to pry candy bars out of a vending machine. Look, I'll find him.
That's all of them.
I can use this. Scrap. So you filled up your can. Ah, shit, marauders.
Kid, hang on. I'm coming.
Mr. St. John? Oh, thank God. Thank God.
It's just Deke, kid.
They were talking about... They were gonna cut me up. They were gonna eat me.
Oh, Jesus. Okay, you got this? Can you get your gas, then get your ass back up to camp? You got it?
Yes, sir.
God damn it, sir. Don't call me sir. It's Deacon.
Yes, sir. Yeah, thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Deacon.
All right, let's see what the old man's got to say. You know a way over the Tielsen Pass. You told me once that
I told you nothing. Go on. Oh, I can't help you, Deke.
Just draw me a goddamn map.
After everything you've done.
After everything that I've... What about what you've done, old man? Huh? Sherman's camp, the things that you
get
did.
Out of here. Hey, you leave me.
Listen
me.
To me. What if you could take it all back, huh? What if you could fix it? The night that I put Sarah on a chopper, I felt relieved. How fucked up is that? I was relieved. Mike, that's what I've been living with.
And now you're chasing ghosts. You think finding your old lady, if she's alive, you think that's gonna fix it? Make you whole?
I don't know, but I gotta try.
All right. If I do this, what you want, show you the way over the pass. You don't come back. All right, you promised me you don't come back.
I gotcha.
Shit, now I gotta talk to Boozer.
Well, we're up here pissing our pants.
Deke. What's been keeping you away so long?
Hey, Blair, how are things in the gun trade?
Good choice. Yep. Don't be such a stranger.
Jesus, man. When the Rippers hit us, I thought we were all goners, you know?
Yeah, I know.
I heard what you did, you know. About how you took them on. Christ.
Yeah, well, don't believe everything you hear.
Yep. Hey, Deke, you stay whole out there, man.
Holy shit.
Boozer, I...
Last winter, we were up on Farewell Ridge. We were watching the freaks. Thousands of them. I mean, too many to count.
Yeah, I remember.
All I could think was, every one of us, man, woman, and child, are now homeless. Bunch of goddamn refugees. Yeah. World belongs to them now.
We'll survive.
Yeah, we've been doing that all right. Surviving isn't living. Something Jack used to say,
Doesn't matter when you hit the road, where you're heading out to. But you damn well better know where you're coming home to.
You know, we never talked about it. While we still wore the colors all this time out in the freak show and shit like this didn't matter anymore.
Yeah, but I think. Last two mongrels on Earth, farewell originals.
The biker boys, most badass drifters on the broken road.
Damn straight.
Yeah, I guess we did become sort of a brand.
We were a lot of things, but we were never a brand.
When we wrote out a farewell, without Sarah, without Jack, or anyone, I knew that we were leaving everything behind. Everything that mattered was gone. Except this.
You're a nomad again, huh?
Yep, I guess I am.
Come on, Jack. Inside, let's go. If she's out there, you'll find her.
Deke, you ready?
Yeah, Mike, I'm ready.
Meet me at the gate. Don't keep me waiting.
Yeah, sure, Mike. Whatever you say. Hey.
Heard Big Mike is taking you over the pass?
Yep.
You really think she's still alive? Billions of people are dead, but somehow she made it.
Hey, we made it, didn't we? If I give up now, if I don't do this, well, then I'm just gonna end up like
us, right? Like Iron Mike, like Boozer? Would you call us campers? Yeah?
You go. And you find your woman. You know where to find me.
You know what? You know what I think, Deacon? I think that you're afraid to be here. You're afraid to be a part of something. We need you here, and that scares the hell out of you.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, me too.
You ready?
Yeah, I want to get the hell out of here.
Come on, this way.
Okay, I'm following you.
Jack out fishing once, before, you know.
No shit.
I got one. Didn't know what the hell to do with it.
That sounds like Jack.
You ran a pretty tight club. Or you boys raised some hell back in the day. I don't think you murdered anyone.
Not in cold blood. It's not murder if they shoot at you first. You know how many tourists we used to get through here come summer?
A few.
Thousands. Too many to count. Highway be bumper to bumper with SUVs and campers chock full of sunburned moms, beer-chugging dads, and their snot-nosed kids. Goddamn rainbow, floppy hats, Hawaiian shirts, and flippy-flops. All summer long they come. Like a trail of colorful ants from L.A. to Farewell to here, nonstop.
I'm glad I avoided road trips out here that time of year.
This is as far as I go. Keep following the trail. It'll take you down the mountain, on into the Diamond-like Valley. I wish you luck. Hope you're right about your old lady still being alive.
She is.
Well, maybe so. But you gotta ask yourself, Deke, what does it matter if everyone else is dead?
Never know what tomorrow may bring. One light next to you could be a memory. I've idolized, I've memorized your face, just in case the need lasts me eternity. It's a shame. That it ain't enough for me. Life's for the live, I won't be giving up. 'Cause you taught me how to, you taught me how to love. Take all I cherish, beat me till my body's numb. Life's for the living, I won't be giving up on you.
life's for the living. I won't be giving up on you. On you. Even though I know you would tell me to.
If you're out there, I'll find you.
What the hell?
You.
Yeah.
Oh, Jesus.
I don't know what we would have done without you, man.
Oh, come on.
Hey, okay, all right, all right, all right. It's dead. It's cool.
Man of the hour.
Oh, God.
I'm Russell, Glenn Russell. This is Private Mullins.
Rick. Hey, Rick. I'm Deacon St. John. Did you say private?
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Deschutes County Militia.
You're not from around here. You come over the pass?
No. I've just been drifting. I came over the salt flats east of Silver Lake.
What? What the hell are you doing out here, man? How'd you get across the 97?
Whoa. Jesus, man.
What?
This guy just saved your freaking life.
The colonel told us to look out for anybody entering the territory, north or south.
Freaking slow your roll, man. We'll let the captain deal with that, okay?
Fine.
He just killed a freaking ranger, dude! Come with us. We got a camp just by Diamond Lake. Get you three hots in a cot. Least we can do.
Okay, yeah, sounds good. What about Flores? We can't just leave him here.
You stay here. I'll come back with some fuel.
No!
Listen, stay here. Use his ammo if you gotta. You'll be fine. Okay?
Following you.
You gotta stick with me, okay? We've been having some trouble with squatters out here the past few weeks. The patrol picks you up, could be trouble.
Okay, got it. So, Deschutes County Militia?
Look, man, all I know is they feed me. They want me to salute them. Yes, sir. I salute and say yes, sir.
How big's your outfit?
The camp out here? We got 100, maybe more. Hard to keep track. Back in HQ, a whole lot more than that.
Yeah, okay. Any women?
Hell, that what you're about? Well, you can forget it. Girls got rules about that. Fraternizing.
Fraternizing!
Yeah, that. Look, you pull your weight, follow orders, nobody messes with you. Women same as the men. Don't matter to the colonel.
I'm not... I'm looking for some people and a woman that I rode with a year back or so. They would have come over from Silver Lake, and they would have been at one of those Nero refugee camps, I think.
Silver Lake? Jesus, man. Silver Lake's been gone a lot longer than that.
Yeah, it's too goddamn easy to lose track of time out of here, you know? Anyway, you guys, do you pick anyone up? Survivors, I mean, from the refugee camp?
Maybe. Like I said, it's a big freaking army, you know? Ask the captain. He came in across the salt flats, I think. He might know.
The captain?
Yeah, Corey. He commands the Diamond Lake outposts. We're almost there. This is it.
It's Corporal Russell. Open up.
Port.
Captain, sir, we had him. We did. Found his bike still smoking.
I bet you lost him, huh?
No, sir. I mean, yeah, we lost him. We ran into a rager, sir.
Where's Mullins? Flores?
Flores is dead, sir. I'll have Mullins with a body.
That'll be all, Corporal. Go get some fuel. Head back to Mullins. You know what to do.
Yeah. Yes, sir. If it wasn't for this man, we'd all be dead, sir. I sort of promised him some food and a safe place to camp tonight, sir.
Corporal, get the fuck out of here. And you are?
Name's Deacon St. John.
Name's Corey. Derek Corey. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm sorry. Sorry, I'm a little tired. I've been on the road for a long time. Your man Russell said you were recruiting.
Are you interested?
I've been looking to settle down. Yeah, find a camp. I'm interested.
Come on.
So, how long you been drifting?
Hard to say. You lose track of time out there, you know?
So, where'd you get your gear? Ammo?
Well, there's a couple of camps I used to do runs for. Bounty hunting, mostly.
Freaks? Or men?
Both. I had a reputation for being able to track shit down, you know?
Well, which camps? Where are they?
You know, past the Farewell Valley. It doesn't matter. They're gone now. They're overrun. Russell said you were there when Silver Lake was overrun.
Yeah. That was a shit show, I can tell you.
Any survivors?
A few.
Move! 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 Come on! You can run faster than that. My dead grandma can run...
Here. Take this. Militia script. Camp credits. Payment for helping my men. Use them at any of the commissaries.
Okay.
You gonna join up? Stick around. We're getting ready to ride out of here soon.
Getting ready to ride out where?
You said you had some tracking skills.
Yeah, some.
This isn't the life of a drifter. We're fighting a war out here. You sure you're up for it?
Is that the best you got?
I can recruit you. But the colonel is the only one who can swear you in. You stick around. Give us a hand. I'll take you to him myself.
I'll be here.
Good.
Jesus. Jesus, motherfucker has my ring. He took it from Sarah. He had to take it from Sarah because she wouldn't have given it to him. So that means that she's got to be here.
Go! 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 You gotta move your ass!
He isn't the
Hell no, you're not. Come on, you gotta work.
Yes, Sergeant.
Moving.
Yes, Sergeant.
Sergeant.
Hey. You don't look very militia to me.
Nah, man. Name's Wade. Wade Taylor. You can call me Wade.
Deacon St. John.
Holy shit. Deacon St. John. Is your old man a preacher or something?
No.
Man, that is a hell of a name.
All right, listen.
You see this, man? This is some crazy shit.
Yeah.
Whew. So what, you joining up, becoming an army man, playing soldier and shit?
I don't know, maybe. Listen, you look like you just came in from out the shit, right?
Yeah, man, yesterday. Okay, yesterday. I've been waiting to see the colonel, whatever the hell that is.
Traveling with some people we got separated. You see anyone that looked like this around here?
Nah, man. Ooh, she is a looker. I'd hit that, you know. I gotta go, man. They're checking me for lice or some shit. Good luck to you, Deacon St. John. Jesus, what a name.
Jesus, that dude's fucked up. He wouldn't remember Sarah if she slapped him in the face. Come on, Sarah. Come on. Where the hell are you? You're here. somewhere. Maybe in these tents. Maybe in here. The infirmary. I mean, with her background, that's where she would be, right?
About their life.
Nope, not here. Check this one. Ah, damn it. She's not here either. It's gotta be the one. Sarah? Sarah, you in here? Shit, not here. Oh, God damn it, she's not here. She's not here, but... Right, yeah, yeah, it couldn't be that easy. Now, could it?
St. John, are you on this channel? Corporal Russell said you had a radio.
Yeah, yeah, I'm here.
Meet me at the gate.
On my way.
Together, keep it together.
Getting ready to ride out. You still coming?
Ready when you are.
Looks like you put a lot of work into this.
Yeah, some.
So that means that the timber was cut before it was burned.
You got a good eye. We call it the dead zone. We use the timber to build our barricades, then burn the slash. From the outpost, we can see a horde coming long before it reaches us.
What? You're gonna burn all the buildings too, so the newts and the swarmers have nowhere to sleep?
You know you're freaks, huh?
Like I said, I've been out in the ship for a long time. So that's your plan, huh? Militia, I mean, to burn everything to the ground?
We're fighting a war out here, St. John. We'll do whatever it takes to win.
A war?
That's what it is, isn't it? A war? You've been out in this shit. You've seen the hordes. The only thing that's gonna stop them is an army. Our army.
It's gonna take way more than an army.
We have a plan. If the Colonel lets you join, we'll fill you in. So, Silver Lake, you asked about survivors. You looking for someone?
No. No, not really. I mean, look, there were some folks that I rode with once, and I thought maybe they ended up there.
I thought maybe you were after something. For a bounty, I mean.
Yeah, no. I tracked men over long distances before, but not this far. No bounty's worth that.
Captain's here.
It's done, sir.
Make sure you make a marker.
Yes, sir.
All right. You two head back to Diamond Lake. Grab, Taylor was his name?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Take him to the Colonel. I'll be there in 1800.
Sir?
Military time, Corporal. You're supposed to know this by now.
Well, yes, sir.
Get the fuck out of here.
Yes, sir.
You find something?
How long is,
Vasquez?
How long has Vasquez been with you guys?
Couple of weeks, maybe more.
Well, he's been busy.
What the hell?
You guys been having trouble with supply runs, marauder attacks?
Yeah.
Okay, we're gonna go on foot from here.
On foot? Why?
Because Vasquez came out here for a reason. I can't track him from the bike. God.
Where do we start?
It's been snowing, so, there won't be any boot prints. Come on, I want to look inside the cabin.
Okay, I'm following you.
You, you said he stole rations, ammo?
Yes.
This is an MRE. It's half-eaten, so looks like your men rode up on him when he wasn't expecting it. His bike's still out front, which means that he went out the back. Wait, over here.
What'd you find?
The fence has been cut. And no rust.
So it was cut recently?
Yeah, come on, this way. Hey, hold on for a second.
Look.
Over here.
Tracks?
Yeah, we're in luck. This way.
Wait, hold up. You find something?
Yeah, shell casing. Recently fired. He stopped to shoot at something. Come on, down here.
Hold up.
Go on, get out of here.
What are you doing? That ever work for you? Yelling at a wolf? Look out! More wolves!
I see him. That's the last of them.
Yeah, it looks like it. Nice work.
Okay, I want to take a look at this thing. Looks like the MREs weren't enough for your man. Clean gunshot, right through the head.
Yeah, the wolves must have heard the shot. Decided they wanted it more than Vasquez.
Yeah, the rest of the pack came at us from back that way, from the east.
You think they chased off Vasquez, leaving one to guard the carcass?
That's my guess.
Come on, let's see if you're right.
You guys got a lot of wolves out here? Ones that aren't infected, I mean?
Yeah, we get reports almost every day.
When I was a kid growing up, there were no wolves in Oregon. I mean, a few coyotes, but no wolves. They've been driven to extinction by ranchers and farmers, timber companies.
Well, it looks like they're making a big comeback.
Hold up.
What is it?
It's a backpack.
It's one of ours.
Looks like they almost got to him.
And he shrugged off the pack to get away.
Nah. To buy time. He landed on his ass. Tried to scramble away, but then the wolf lunged. Vasquez dropped him. Two shots.
You can tell all that.
Yeah.
Wait, get down. A swarm.
Near a gravesite.
This one's not going to run out. They're scattered all over the region.
Yeah, maybe that explains why Vasquez came through here. Let's go around.
Exactly what I was thinking. St. John, this way.
Yeah, right there with you. I gotta say, I'm getting tired running and hiding from these sons of bitches.
You ever take on a swarm?
Yeah, I've done it before. You just gotta keep moving.
Well, look, if you're gonna join the militia, you must stay focused on the mission. We're not out here to fight free.
Being in the shit, killing freaks, it kinda goes hand in hand, doesn't it? Put some distance between us and the graves. The cold weather's gonna bring out even more of them. I think they can smell the corpse from about a mile out.
Part of our slash and burn strategy is to find these grave sites, dig them up, and burn them along with everything else.
Yeah, well, good luck with that. I've seen hundreds of them just in this part of the state alone.
And we gotta start somewhere. All right, where now?
Keep heading east. Hey, there's a road ahead. Hold up a second.
What do you think?
Is anyone else tracking him?
Not that I know of.
Huh. Well, then he's either dead,
Maury's got a lot of friends. You see how his tracks have been overridden by bikes. A lot of bikes.
Hmm. Okay. Come on. Let's see where they're heading.
You said cold weather brings out the freaks?
Yeah. Cold, snow, rain, hell, even clouds.
Well, like I said before, you know your freaks. When we get to command, there's some people who want to talk to you.
People?
The Colonel will fill you in, if he lets you join.
Yeah, I think you said that already.
Look, he runs a tight outfit. I just don't want you to get your hopes up.
Hey, don't worry about me. I don't really give a damn either.
Hey, wait.
Hear that?
Yeah, it's coming from the logging camp over there.
Is that on your map?
Yeah.
Wow, that means it's also on Vasquez's map.
Come on. If Vasquez is there, what would your strategy be?
Well, he's not alone. We know that from the tracks. What's that militia penalty for going AWOL?
Hanging by the neck until dead. Why?
Well, it means Vasquez isn't coming without a fight.
See your man?
Yeah. That's him.
Well, looks like you guys need to start doing background checks on your recruits. He seems to be right at home.
Well, let's wait here. I'll radio for backup.
Get your goddamn hands off me!
Oh, this one's a fighter, boys! What do you think?
Oh, we'll see about that.
Oh, hell no.
What?
I just got this problem with assholes who hurt unarmed women.
I'm giving you an order.
Order? You see me wearing a red armband? You don't give me orders yet. You do whatever the hell you want.
Something.
behind me. You give me cover if you have to. Okay.
Of them.
Yeah, I think so. Nice work.
Come on, let's go deal with your man.
Vasquez? He isn't my man. Not anymore.
Okay, wait here. Stand guard in case we missed anyone.
You can handle him?
He won't know what hit him.
I'm gonna choke the life out of you!
Locked.
Why we were here. Go ahead! Do it!
Don't try, oh. Bitch!
I'd rather screw that knife in your two-inch peck, motherfucker!
Thank you.
it. I can get in through here.
Hey, whoa. Easy, easy. I'm just here to help.
I don't need your goddamn help.
Okay. I'm just gonna move over here.
Stay the hell away from me!
Hold on now. We're not with them.
You think I give a damn who you are?
Okay.
How was that?
Just your typical damsel in distress.
Vasquez?
Done. Way done.
Captain Curry? Come in.
This is Curry.
We're here. Heading up the road to the main gate.
Hold your position there. We're coming.
What about the enemy?
They've been, neutralized. Hold your position. Curry out. Come on.
We brought up your bikes, Captain. Thought we'd save you the walk back.
That'll be all, Corporal.
So how'd I do? Did I pass?
Pass?
Oh, you've been watching me all day. I figured this was what? Some kind of test.
No. Nothing quite as formal as all that. As you can see, our pool of recruits isn't what it used to be.
Yeah.
But yeah. You passed. Third day in a row. Oh. You ready to meet the colonel?
Yeah, sure. Why the hell not?
So, St. John, did you serve? Before the ship went down. And you know what an MRE looks like. You know how to recon an enemy position. You know cover in advance, tactical maneuvers. So, where did you serve? Marines? Army?
I try not to talk about it, you know? I mean, first year out here, it seemed like anyone who used to wear a uniform had a target on their back. I was in the Army, 10th Mountain. I did a full tour in Afghanistan. So how about you? Anyone who's ex-military has a certain berry. None of your soldiers have it, but you do.
Like I said, you got a good eye. I was in the Air Force 10 years, hard as sack.
There ain't no missile silos in Oregon.
I was on vacation, believe it or not. I was lucky. Before SATCOM went down, I got hourly reports from across the country. You think it was bad out here? Everything east of the Mississippi was overrun within 2 days. Hold up. I want to show you something.
So, are you familiar with this area?
Yeah. I grew up in a town north from here. It's called Farewell. You know it?
No. It sounds like a fitting place to be living at the end of the world.
Yeah. Tell me about it.
So maybe you have been here before.
Yeah, I've been here. A few summers back, me and my old lady, or my wife, we
stopped by here on her honeymoon.
You got a pic? Of your wife, I mean. Her name was Carrie. We were married 12 years when... Anyway, it was a long time ago.
You know, I think this might mean keep out.
Huh? Oh, no, that doesn't apply to us.
Why, because we can't read?
Because we don't obey the law.
Speak for yourself.
After you.
All right. You know, making me a co-conspirator, not very chivalrous.
Chival what?
No, it means, right. I never learn. I'm sorry about that.
Oh my God, you should have seen the look on your face.
Oh, I bet it was funny.
Yeah, if I'd owned a cell phone, I'd have taken a picture.
Well, for just this once, I'm glad that you don't.
Oh, come on, don't start on that again.
Hey, I didn't say anything. You brought it up.
You just did.
So, where are we going?
Just follow the trail. You'll see that it's not that far.
What would my mom say if she knew I was out on a midnight stroll in the middle of nowhere with an outlaw biker?
I don't know. She'd say, honey, you better wear your sweater.
Very funny.
Yeah, she wouldn't say anything, you know? You weren't supposed to tell them about us, remember?
Oh, come on, Deacon, I said that a long time ago. You know I didn't mean that.
Hey, look, I'm not judging. I haven't told my old man.
That's because your father's dead.
Well, yeah, I mean, there's that.
The question is, have you told anyone in the MC that you're dating a nice girl from Seattle and not some bimbo from whatever strip club you guys live in?
Oh, wait a second. No, we don't live in a strip club. I mean, we have a lifetime membership there. That's true, but we don't live there. And second, I did tell them. Yeah, matter of fact, I did.
Wait, you did?
Yeah. Oh, come on, don't sound so surprised. They find your PhDs to be very sexy.
I bet. So, you know this is way past my bedtime.
Oh, I know.
Come on, stop. I mean, I really do have to get up early tomorrow.
Yeah? How's that going? I mean, you never want to talk about it, so...
It's nothing. It's just... it's just this project. I mean, we've got these execs flying in from New York to audit our progress, and the suits at our facility are installing a new lab without even showing me the spec, and...
Ooh, well, I thought you didn't want to talk about it.
Sorry, it's just... You know, like I said, it's nothing. Anyway, thank you for dragging me away from all that.
Yeah, no problem.
Wait, is this a pop farm? Is this what you wanted to show me?
Say what?
Well, these are marijuana plants, and that's an irrigation system, so this here, this is a pot farm.
Oh, hey, yeah, look at that, pot farm.
You dragged me out in the middle of the night to the middle of nowhere to show me the MC's illegal growing operation.
Yeah, I mean, you got me. I was hoping that you could give us some tips, you know, cultivation. Put all those PhDs to work on something actually useful.
Jesus, Deacon, what? Okay, I get it. This is not actually what you wanted to show me, right?
No, of course it's not. Come on,
keep following the trail. We're almost there.
Ugh, you think I would learn? You think I would learn, but I never learn.
Nope.
Oh, my God. God, look at that moonlight. It's so beautiful.
Keep going. We're almost there.
You ever wonder what it would be like if just everywhere all at once the lights went out and everyone could just see the world just like this?
What, you mean, like all dark and shadowy and depressing?
I mean the moonlight, the wildflowers, the fireflies. Oh, I see you were kidding again. Okay, you don't take anything seriously.
Oh, I take everything seriously.
Oh, yeah, right.
I do.
You do not. Like when I suggested moving some of my stuff over to your place, you pretended that I was joking.
No, that's not true. I pretended I didn't hear you. There's a big difference.
You should have seen the look on your face. And you know, I do have a cell phone and I took a picture. You want me to show you?
My God, you're a scientist. Can we be rational about this?
Okay. First of all I said is that we should think about moving in together. You know, because we get to spend more time together and, you know, take the next step. What's irrational about that?
I have a toothbrush at your place.
Oh, I'm so sorry. You know what? You're right. That is a huge commitment.
Well, I mean, do you know how much a good toothbrush costs?
Okay, see, there you go again. Every time I try to talk about our future, you turn it into a joke.
Okay, all right. We do need to talk about it, and we will talk about it, but just hold on for a second, because I want to show you something, okay? See? This is why I brought you out here.
Wow, how beautiful.
Was it worth it?
God, yes.
Hey, there's something I've been meaning to ask you.
Yeah? Deacon?
Will you...
Will I?
Will you, So that a yes?
On two conditions.
Name them.
Okay, well, the first one is that we don't have one of those biker weddings where you say that you're going to ride me as much as your bike.
Done. I couldn't promise that anyway.
Oh, stop. Okay, the second one is that you never leave me.
Done.
God, did you just break your biker ring off my finger?
You know what? I think I probably did.
Look at it. It's so cute with its little fangs just like clenching onto the chain. You know, nothing says true love like
dog skulls.
Dog skulls. Hey, what does it say there?
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you knew Latin.
Come on.
It's Morier Invictus. It means death before defeat.
Wow, I like that. Well, you're gonna get me. Real ring, though, right? Not that this one's not
absolutely
great.
Because
I just
thought that's my ring,
right? It's your ring. Right. Something more simple without fangs.
Okay.
All right. Oh, shit, I'm sorry.
No, it's your ring.
It's the lab. I gotta get it.
Okay.
Hello? Yeah, no, it's fine. I'll be right there. Okay, bye.
Is everything okay?
I don't know. They need me back there. What? I gotta go.
This minute? Like, this time of night?
I'm sorry. I have to go, but I promise I'll make it up to you.
Okay.
Come on.
My wife's name was, Beth. No, I don't have a pick.
Let's go.
Not unusual, you know.
I'm sorry, what's that?
To not have any photos of your wife, family.
Yeah, why do you say that?
Back in the day, everyone used smartphones. That's where we kept all our photos. When phones went away, the cloud went away, our photos went with them.
Yeah, I guess I hadn't thought about that.
My wife, Carrie, her father was a photographer. Old school, dark room, chemicals, all that. Too stubborn to embrace the digital age, I think. If it wasn't for him, I wouldn't have any photos either.
Yeah, well, I hated him. Cell phones, I mean. Seemed like everyone walked around with their noses buried in the damn things. I never owned one.
Interesting. How'd you manage that?
I worked as a mechanic. I had my own shop. Probably had the last landline in Farewell.
What's up, soldier?
Now you're gonna pay.
You guys are taking this shit seriously.
The Colonel believes with enough motivation and discipline, we can achieve anything.
Come on, hurry your ass up.
I'm going as fast as I can.
Just move it!
Is that your idea of motivation?
The Colonel has set up a work camp on the south side of the island for those unfit to serve. Some of them require extra encouragement.
I'll bet.
Come on, follow me.
Yes, sir.
Stand up there with the others. Good luck, St. John.
Got your ass too, huh? Whatever.
Hey, man. It's good to see you again. St. John, right? Son of a preacher man?
Taylor, what's this son of a preacher man shit you keep saying?
I'm just kidding with you, man. Hey, do you have any luck?
What?
The woman you were looking for, you and your peeps are riding with.
No.
I need all your jewelry, watches, shit like that. Come on, in the bag.
Sure, man, whatever you say.
The hell you say?
Recruits aren't allowed personal effects. Besides, shit's just gonna get stolen. Come on, cough it up.
Yeah, shit's gonna get stolen.
Goddamn bullshit.
Ten hot! At ease. Visitors are not welcome here. You are here because you were invited, recruited by my trusted officers. When you answer me, start by giving me your name, last name first.
Getting by, same as everybody.
Name.
Atkins, Crystal, sir.
How many men have you killed?
Before or after?
Answer the question.
Fuck you!
We have all done things that we're not proud of.
What?
To survive. To stay alive. The Almighty understands this. The Almighty forgives this.
Amen! Amen!
But here... upon this woman's face are the footprints of Satan. Prison tattoos. Proof of what you once were and no doubt still are. It's people like her that are responsible for bringing the wrath of the Almighty down upon us all. Yeah. Take her to the work camp.
What? Fuck you. Get her out of here. Fuck
you
all.
Come on, gorgeous. Let's
go. Goddamn redneck assholes. Get off of me. Swear to God.
What about you?
Taylor. Wait. And, no, sir. I never been to jail. Never killed anyone, nothing like that.
You've been in the shit for a long time.
Yeah, I mean, I know how to shoot stuff. My dad took me hunting when I was a kid. I was at a camp near Klamath Falls.
And how about you, son? You know how to use a gun?
St. John, Deacon. Yeah, I know how to use a gun.
You're a drifter. Hold out your right arm. 10th Mountain. Iraq?
Afghanistan.
Honorable service, and don't lie to me. I'll know.
Served one tour, served with honor. Hated every goddamn minute of it.
Thou shalt not lie. Good man. Hold up your right hand. Do you solemnly swear to support and defend the new Constitution of these United States? Against all enemies, natural and unnatural, to bear witness and support to the same, and to obey all orders without question. So do you swear?
I swear.
Dismissed! Walk with me, son.
How's it going?
Captain Curry doesn't bring me many recruits these days. He must think highly of your combat skills.
I've been in the shit a long time.
You know your way around the freaks?
Yes, sir. I know as much as anyone, sir.
Good, good. In here. We'll have the doc take a look at you.
Pulse is strong. Good heart rate. Got a pretty nasty burn there. How'd that happen?
Had a run-in with a wood stove.
Wood stove, huh? Who dressed this?
I did.
No está mal. Not bad at all.
Thank you.
Keep it dressed or you're gonna lose that arm. You hear me, amigo?
Yeah, I hear you.
I want you to check back with me in a few days.
Got it.
Well, Doc?
He's fit to serve. Lo hará bien. You doing runs out in the shit?
Sorry, Doc. Tiene novia. He's spoken for.
Let me guess. The Wizard Island Witch. Vaya con Dios. Good luck, amigo.
Let's go, son. I normally don't tolerate insubordination, referring to an officer as a witch. But I make exceptions for some of my more eccentric officers.
Yes, sir.
I make exceptions because every man and woman still living has a role to play. Do you believe in God, St. John?
Never gave it much thought, sir.
Well, it's high time that you did. He has a plan for us, all of us. And my part is this.
Sir?
This place. I had a vision. Oh, nothing so grand as those described in the Old Testament. No flaming chariots or burning bushes. I simply woke up one morning before God's plague had rained down upon the world and knew that this was the place.
Crater Lake, Wizard Island?
I call it the Ark. Are you familiar with the story?
Yeah, I mean, yes, sir. I mean, everyone's heard of it.
Indeed. You'd be surprised how few have read the Bible or the Book of Revelations.
You mean Genesis, Noah's story. I mean, it's the Book of Genesis, sir.
Yes, of course. Okay, son, let's get you squared away.
Whatever you say.
Now, we don't have much in the way of uniforms, I'm sorry to say, but I think that... Here. Try this on.
Seems to fit.
I'll take that.
Well, if you don't mind, this is a gift from an old friend.
An old friend? Not many of those left anymore, are there?
No, there are not.
Okay, soldier. But I don't want to see you wearing it. You're one of us now. And normally we start new recruits in the rank of private. But since Captain Curry has vouched for your experience in the field, we are starting you out at the rank of corporal. Congratulations, son.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Let's get you some work.
All right. Now, what was I saying?
You were telling me about the Ark, sir.
Yes, the Ark. What you see here is only a small part of it. Behind us is a whole network of caves and vents that lead from here up to the Cone's Peak. When our work is complete, they will be filled with thousands of seeds, plants, computer files, and books. The world may die, but our achievements in medicine, science, and technology will not die with it.
No, sir.
But the island is more than just an ark, Corporal. It is a stronghold, a fortress. Here at the North Gate, we are stockpiling enough munitions to take the fight to the Freaks. We have rifles, grenades, heavy machine guns, and RPGs. We have the equipment to make ammunition. Every type, every caliber. This is our mechanical engineering area. If you need your bike repaired, see the officer on duty. And as you can see here, courtesy of the old National Guard, we are building a fleet of trucks and other vehicles. Once the hordes are cleared from the highways, we will begin to rebuild the roads and bridges.
Your slash-and-burn strategy may stop newts and swarmers, but it won't clear the highway. It won't stop the hordes, sir.
We are aware, Corporal. The hordes. The hordes are a different beast entirely, aren't they? But we have a plan.
Plan, sir?
Benjamin Franklin once said, by failing to prepare, you are preparing to fail. We are not going to fail. The heart of the army lives here, at the gate, ready to move on my command. These tents house hundreds of women and men, just like yourself, who have pledged and sworn their lives to the fight. But I have something else in mind for you. An assignment that requires more than just the ability to survive in the shit or use a gun. Are you up for it, son?
Yes, sir. Wherever you need me.
You asked how we were going to defeat the Horde. Let me show you.
Hey, my bad.
Now! Shit!
You okay, Lieutenant?
Oh. Hey, Colonel. Sorry about that. Too much acetone in that batch.
Lieutenant Weaver is our chemical engineer. He's working on new ways to
blow shit up!
Defeat the enemy.
Sorry. But, yeah. Name's Weaver. James.
St. John, Deacon.
All this militia shit's just for show. Right, Colonel?
Corporal St. John is new to Corey's unit. If you need anything from out in the shit, he's your man.
Oh, shit, yeah. There's a couple of things I need.
What are you working on?
Oh, just the new gelling agent combining naphthenic and palmitic acid.
You working on napalm?
Yeah. Yeah. This dude knows his shit.
Just a lucky guess.
Sorry to interrupt.
Oh, anytime. Oh, Colonel. I'm getting real close, Colonel. Very close.
That's good. That's really good.
Where you going next, Colonel? Wizard Island Witch?
That'll be all, Lieutenant.
Again, let me apologize for my more eccentric officers.
No need, sir.
We have one final stop. As much as I believe in Lieutenant Weaver's work, what you're about to see could be, I think, our path to victory. In here.
All right, what is this?
Ma'am, I got everything on the requisition form.
Does this look like fabric softener?
No, ma'am.
Okay, why don't you read it?
Active ingredients. Chloroform and A-terpen...
Get out. Shit. Get out! Matt, I can't do this if I have to do my own supply runs.
I got it covered. Lieutenant Whitaker, this is Corporal St. John. He's a new member of Khoury's unit. He's got some experience out in the shit.
Read this.
What?
Read this. I mean, you can read, can't you?
Active ingredients, chloroform, a-terpenol, benzo alcohol, ethylacetic acetate.
Good enough. When can he start?
I'll leave you to it. Carry on, Lieutenant.
Leave us.
Sarah.
Stand at attention.
Sarah, I...
Don't. Dead. You're supposed to be dead.
Hey.
You're dead.
It's okay.
You're dead.
I'm right here.
Wait a second. I don't understand. I couldn't find you.
I thought you had died, and
No, we were overrun. We had to go south. Nero said that no one made it out.
O'Brien and
Farewell
I
was
away.
Overrun. They said that everybody
over the
was
mountain.
Dead.
And I didn't think that.
I never thought I would see you again.
Hey, listen. Now we can ride out of here. We'll pick a direction. We won't look back. Come on.
No, Deacon. I can't.
They're forcing you to stay here?
No, you don't understand. We're fighting a war. Don't you see? This is a war that we can win.
I didn't come here to fight a war.
I can be helpful. I can make a difference, but I can't go with you. I have to stay here. Don't you get it? You can stay here with me. Help me. Look, afterwards, whatever you say, we can go wherever you want.
Colonel's looking for you.
Whatever you say, ma'am.
Wait a second. Your requisition form. Thank you, soldier.
Corporal St. John to Lieutenant Weaver. Come back. St. John to HQ.
This is Weaver. What can I do for you,
Hey, what are you doing here?
Your requisition form says you need mercury. Any idea where I can get it?
Yeah, sure. I should have written that shit down for you. It comes from, Cinnabar. Corey's unit scouted out of mine north of Diamond Lake. Head there, radio me when you arrive.
Yes, sir.